Alright, we're going to stick around for a few seconds here just to show you what happens when the time does run out and why you really don't want to be around here. 3, 2, 1, and... Unrelenting Anvil Storm. Yeah. Well, hello everyone, and welcome back to Dodge That Anvil with me, Philadelphus. We're on field 1-4 here, Midnight Harvest. Oh yeah, you can also change your controller mid-save game if you feel like it, but I'm sticking to the keyboard here. So, we've got Midnight Harvest. Let's get to it. And you can see it's still winter here. Snow covering the ground. Every now and then, the anvil storm ceases for a night, leaving us free to harvest. However, these brief lulls are always followed by heavy precipitation in the morning, so you absolutely must leave the field before sunrise. Thank you, Professor Lupin. So yes, he's quite right. Every couple of levels, you'll get a level like this, where you have a certain amount of time limit, where you can collect as many vegetables as you can, and then there will be an unending anvil storm at the end of it. So, let's jump right into it here. Make sure my hands are on the right keys here. Alright, so we're going to run over here and start picking as many crops as we can over this way. And that timer up there tells us how long until dawn, and how long we have until the anvils start dropping. So, luckily there should be just enough time to get everything in this field if we're fast. You got dynamite! Use this to destroy rocks or unearth carrots. Press shift to light the fuse, then run away. And we're going to hold on to this because it will let us finish the entire level. Well, it will let us hopefully get everything in the level, I should say. So yeah, dynamite can be used to blow up rocks, or it can also be used to unearth crops really quickly. So if I plant this in the middle of that field, for instance, it would blow up all the crops at once, which is quite handy. And there's a block down here, which is a Vegemagnet, which will make this much, much easier. So Vegemagnets apparently do not carry over with you, which is a slight annoyance, but nothing I can do about that. But luckily they give us one here, because otherwise having to pick up every single vegetable would slow us down quite a bit. So we'll use the dynamite over there to break those rocks, and that will let us get up here. Otherwise you wouldn't be able to jump up there. And in this box we find a stopwatch, which we're going to use for an extra 10 seconds here to just collect all the crops up here, which is quite handy. You should be able to get everything in this field, I think. So we've got another 2 seconds on the clock here, so we'll use that. There we go. Alright, and we're going to finish this in plenty of time, actually. Very nice. I do love how the music gets more intense as the countdown gets closer and closer towards dawn. You listen to it in the background there. Alright, just make sure we get everything here. Well, there we go, that's all the carrots. Alright, we're going to stick around for a few seconds here just to show you what happens when time does run out and why you really don't want to be around here. 3, 2, 1, and... Unrelenting Anvil Storm. Yeah, you really don't want to be around here when it's daylight. Especially because I didn't have a hard hat. That was really dangerous, I just realized. But we got a perfect harvest out of that, so that's amazing. And on to the next level. Oh, that's right. So every four levels or so, you get an Advanced Harvesting Protocol Report, Season 1, by Lavender Lupin. The first season of our Advanced Harvesting Project was a success. I must admit that I had my doubts about meeting our quotas with only one volunteer, but our new harvester has done an amazing job. Plus, he's kind of cute. Also worth noting is the fact that our Cratapults and Beach Ball Cannons seem to have been effective in disrupting the Anvil Storm. We can only hope that things will go as smoothly if the anvils return next year. Indeed we can, Lavender. Indeed we can. Alright, so yeah, when a new season begins, you can revisit a lot of fields by selecting their icons on the map. You can harvest them once per season. So basically, you can go back and you can harvest them for additional bonus crops if you need them. If you want a larger collection of bonus crops for buying things later on. Yeah, so that's cool. The ones like the one we just did with the Anvil Storm there, those generally can't be redone. You can only do those basically once per game. So, but all the others you can go back and do if you really want to. You know, run around. But anyway, we're on to the next one here. Season 2-1, Beach Ball Bombs. Sounds interesting. Got a decently sized field here. The thing is, we go on, the levels actually get bigger and bigger. Typically. A lot of water down here. Good thing about those flippers on. We have a small problem. It seems that some of our beach balls are behaving strangely in the anvil storm. Our engineers have termed them beach ball bombs. If you see any, it would be wise to run or kick them away. So yes, this introduces us to a new mechanic here. Explosive beach balls that will drop occasionally in place of anvils. Let's use the stopwatch to do some harvesting here. May as well use it, since we've been given it. There we go. This new anvil. Alright, and we get a crate early on. That's always nice. I'm not entirely sure how much this is RNG and how much of it is just scripted to show up per level, because there's sort of a limit, and that's a beach ball bomb. Okay, that was close. So yeah, those explode, and they will happily kill you if you don't have a armored vest on when you're too close to them. That was kind of just at the edge there, so we got kind of lucky there. So yeah, now you never know when a beach ball falls, if it's going to be a regular beach ball or a bomb. Yeah, in the hole. There we go. Alright, welcome to Hole Mart. Our stylish yet functional armor vests are now on sale. And we're going to buy one for the low cost of 2 radishes there. Also going to buy a hard hat, and I'll go all the way up to a huge veggie magnet and spend most of my radishes, and hope I don't immediately lose it by getting blown up or conked on the head or something. I do like how most of the equipment in this game is kind of pretty nicely balanced. The armor vest is useful for protecting you against explosions. Flippers are good for helping you in water and protecting you from ice. There's just kind of a lot of kind of multi-use stuff. So yeah, kind of does a good job of. Let's move away from that. Does a good job of keeping anything from being too overpowered or too underpowered, really. I suppose the flippers and the armor vest aren't as necessary, but they're still pretty handy. Oh, that's another beach ball bomb. So yeah, you can see it though. You can bounce them off your head. They won't actually hurt you until they blow up. Alright, now we got another stopwatch here. Oh, okay, that was close. I almost walked into that. That could have been bad. They fall on me, anvil. Well, they fall right nearby you. They shake the ground, but they can actually cancel your crop picking animations if you're not careful. Another crate. What's in the box this time? Oop, I just jumped off the edge there. Yeah, it's another umbrella. I wanted that. But I want the stopwatch. There we go. No, I want the stopwatch. There we go. Thank you. Alright, get away from these beach ball bombs. Run! It's basically serpentine the game. Dodging the anvils. Alright, let's finish up this field here. And now, if we look over here, there's a little patch up here that we can't actually get to. Because these rocks are blocked off. Now there's 2 ways we could get into this. We could drop a beach ball bomb. We'd wait around here until we get a beach ball bomb and let it blow up some of the rocks for us, which is an entirely viable strategy that'll work just fine. In fact, I might wait until I get a beach ball and try and show it off, just to show you how it works here. I want another anvil. I want a beach ball. Gonna take that on the head. I just realized. Alright, so that's our anvil. That's our current quota reached. We can actually leave now. Let's see if this is a beach ball bomb. It is an. Gotta light it right next to it. Okay. The explosion knocked it away. Stop moving it! Alright, well, there's another way we can do this. And one that I'm going to show off here as soon as I harvest this field. Come here, you shy radish, you. I shall harvest you. There we go. The other thing we can use is these things over here. I'm back going, what on earth are those? Those. Let me just pick one here. Get all the carrots. And I'll show you. If I can remember my keys here. These are veggie bombs. These can be used in the same way as dynamite, except that the fuse is already lit. You'll have to plant it and run away before it explodes. So, yeah. Be careful when you pick these. The small ones have a 6-second fuse here. We'll go plant it over by the rocks there. And run away! Let me see how it blows up the rocks, and then they will let us go through here. And so we've got all the carrots, so we've actually got pretty much everything in this level. I might just go buy a hard hat really quick, because I don't want to be without one. In we go. Welcome to Hole Mart again. I would just like to buy one of your hard hats. Thank you. Come down here and pick up an umbrella along the way. And then we're going to head up to that spot that I opened up with the dynamite there, and the veggie bomb. Yeah, as you can see how the umbrella gives you quite a lot more airtime. We might actually be able to get there just with an umbrella, I don't know. I've tried it. Or maybe I whip. Or we could just run off the edge like that. Good job. Oh yeah, that will actually allow us to make it. Okay, so you don't even need to blow that stuff up at all. You just need an umbrella. But anyway, this is not the exit that we were pointed to in the little cutscene there. That was over here. So this is the main exit, the normal exit. If you can't make it to this area, this is an optional exit. It's going to take us to somewhere special. So let's head over here. And we've got all the carrots, and secret exit. Alright, got every carrot, every radish. Doing good. Now back in the overworld here, you see we have our normal progression, Frog River. We also have secret challenge number one from that secret exit, and that's where we are going to go. We see a bunch of rocks, we see a very interestingly shaped level here. We see a bunch of rocks. It's a rather cool level design. And us. Who are you? Who sent you here? Were you followed? Oh, you're with Professor Lupin. Looking for some special training, then? The important thing to know is that mistakes made here will not count against you in the regular harvest. On the other hand, if you succeed at the challenge, you will win a prize of many bonus crops. In this challenge, your task is to destroy all of the rocks within 45 seconds. If you fall off or get knocked out, you will have to start again. The prize for completing this challenge is 50 bonus crops. So yeah, these are special challenges. Secret challenge. I'll do it. And basically, they're just extra challenges you can get for extra bonus crops, which is really handy if you're low on bonus crops. Alright, so once you get on the island here, let's start a countdown. And we basically have to destroy all these rocks using anvils and explosive beach balls within the 45 seconds there. So basically, you want to try and use anvils to destroy the single ones, and oh! You also want to try to avoid getting hit. But the nice thing about this is that it doesn't count against you, so you can get killed as many times as you want. And it'll just restart. So let's use some anvils on... Ooh, okay, that was close. Ooh! So yeah, we want to use beach balls on the multi-rock clusters here, basically. And use anvils to destroy the single ones. Ooh, that was close. I almost jumped into that. That could have been bad. Let's go over here and drop a beach ball. And one final anvil should do it if I... Oh, rats, I fell off the island! And I got reset. And wow. Okay. Let's try this again. All right. Restart. Actually, I suppose a beach ball right in the middle there would be a good way to clear out those two, but we'll go with the anvils for now. Yes, got that one lined up very well. Got this one. Don't fall off. I want to set this. Oh, rats! I bounced that anvil, that beach ball. All right, we can't really wait for more beach balls here to... Oh, we're going to need one now to destroy that. Oh, wow. Taken out by a secondary bounce. So yeah, that's a thing that can happen. Anvils are not only dangerous because they're falling straight down. The secondary bounces can... I really wasted that beach ball, didn't I? The secondary bounces can be just as deadly. And can be really annoying when it happens to you. Alright, beach ball, quick. Let's get it over here. Let's hope that's close enough. I think that is just close enough. Drop it on there. Alright, we're doing alright here so far. And yes, there we go. Alright, we got all the anvils there. Pops up a little extra hole here. Jump across, go up here. And we come up to a field full of bonus crops. So these... The very large ones here are giant crops. Basically, we have the normal ones that are worth one, the fat carrots, the fat radishes that we saw, they're worth three, and these that are worth five each, but take a significant amount of effort to pull out of the ground. So instead of doing that, we're going to use dynamite, which will blow them all off the ground instantly. Oops! Never mind, we're going to use a veggie bomb. So, cool thing is that, so they'll blow stuff out of the ground immediately, just like that. Although explosions do not have any effect on other veggie bombs, thankfully, or you'd have a whole bunch of Once you die, you're getting blown out of the ground. So yeah, just run around and pick up all these bonus crops. That should let us buy whatever we want for a while. We can just head back here. Luckily, you can fall, I think, any distance without taking fall damage. I'm not 100% sure, but you kind of slow down a little bit when you hit the ground. But anyway, that's that challenge complete. So, on to the next one. And here we are, Field 2-2, Frog River. I wonder why it's called that. Alright, so this field introduces lily pads, which are those things moving around, and you can jump on them in the water. They let you get up to places that you might not be able to jump to otherwise. If you want to cross this river, you'll have to do as the frogs do. Simply hop across the lily pads as quickly as you can. Some of the lily pads move around, so bear that in mind as well. Thank you, Professor. So yeah, the other thing about lily pads is they kind of tend to sink with your body weight, so you have to be careful with that. It'll make it a little bit difficult to game around. Usually not too bad. We'll see how things go here. Get all the crops here. Okay, that was just a regular beach ball. Those do still exist. Ooh, that was close. So yeah, but you can also get anvils landing on them. Let me up. Yeah, there's a box hiding down here. Dynamite! Excellent. We'll just plunk it down right here and get out of the way. So beach balls, because you don't actually plant them in the ground, they don't blow crops out of the ground. Like dynamite. Right now, to get up here, we have to jump off of this lily pad, but luckily we made it. First try. Not always quite that good. Ooh, okay, that was close. That could have hurt. And we got an umbrella. Well, that's good. That'll help us get around a little bit easier. And avoid... Oops. So you do have to have your umbrella open for it to protect you from anvil drops, otherwise it won't help you. But that's not usually too big a deal. Oh, I'm gonna lose my heart out. I just realized that. Ah, shucks. I'm still occasionally really bad at timing just how long things are going to take. There are some very annoying shy crops in this field. Draw anvil. Alright. Well, we're making some good progress here. That radish. Come here, you. Come here. Oop, whoa. So I think anvils that get blown around by explosions can also damage you as well, so just be careful of anvils falling on your head, okay? It's dangerous. Since there's a hole marked up here, let's pick up a Vegemagnet. In fact, all Vegemagnets are now on sale! So we're going to pick up some of those. We've got plenty of bonus crops. Look at the full harvest. Full set of armor here as well. Now that makes collecting vegetables so much easier. And there's a daisy over there, which means we're going to see lavender around here somewhere. Oh, dynamite. Alright. Well, let's go figure out where we can plant this. Help us harvest. Ah, we've got another field with another veg bomb right there. We've also got some... Whoop, away from that. We've also got another inaccessible place, so let's plunk some dynamite down there and move away. Explosions going off everywhere! We'll just use this Vegibomb here to harvest a bit more of this field. There we go. Now we can now get up to that area up there. So let's go ahead and do so. And there's a daisy up there. We'll just grab it while we're here. So daisies always mean there's going to be a burrow for lavender somewhere on the map, so you can get some extra lives. I did actually check this between recordings. It is the case that, bringing one daisy will get you one life. Bringing two daisies will get you three lives, and bringing three daisies will get you five, so that's quite nice. Now we just need to figure out where she's gone. Oh, alright, we've filled our carrot quota here. We can now head out if we want to. But we're not quite done yet, so we've got to check under these rocks here. Oh, that's not a bomb. Okay, just a normal beach ball. That one's a bomb, though. And that's an umbrella. Oh, that's a bomb as well. And there was a daisy hiding under that rock, which we'll just pick up. There we go. Just destroy this rock here. And there we go. Hi there, another bouquet of daisies. You are just too sweet, tall enough to get a bigger vase. Did you know that it's time to set the clocks back already? You did? Oh well, I guess I've been living under a rock. Oh! I just realized I was going to explode. Well, it's a good thing I was wearing my safety vest there. That could have ended badly otherwise. I'll just pick up the last few vegetables here. Oop. Need to get over here. Actually, jump up on top of this. I didn't realize that. Oh, explosion blew me off course. That can be kind of annoying. Oh, come on, I want to get up there. Get me up. Oop. There we go. Oop. All right, so we are missing one carrot so far. Stopwatch. Okay, that was close. I'll actually keep hold of this umbrella. Alright, where is this last carrot that I'm apparently missing? Let's pick up a vest here. Oops. Go shopping. Get my full complement of armor on. There we go. Alright, so I'm apparently missing one carrot somewhere. I'm guessing. Not down here. I cannot quite make an umbrella, so that's where we need the lily pads there. So yeah, those logs actually kind of move around, as you can see. They will, you can get a Oh yeah, so if you stand on one side... Oh, that's not what I wanted. If you stand on one side, the anvils will actually target the other end. Alright, I don't want to explode beach ball. Give me another anvil. So if I stand on this end, an anvil will actually target the other end, and they can actually launch you pretty high into the air, and that allows me to see the other characters over here. And now we have them all. We visited Lavender for extra lives, so into the hole we go. And we have another perfect harvest. And yeah, that seesaw elevator, seesaw log action will definitely come in handy in later levels. So, anyway, we've got all the carrots and all the branches there. And I think that's about time to call it for this episode. Next episode, we will continue on with Field 2-3 Blue Ribbon Crop. But until then, I've been Philadelphus, and I'll see you all in the next video.